Guys, I'm so glad that you reminded me that it's Thursday because it's all just become a blur. I know, Ben, yesterday you were pointing out that maybe I hadn't fully embraced working from home in my leather pants. So I thought, you know what? He's right. I'm just going to go for it. So this is me working from home.
This is leaning into it.
You know what? You know under there, like her hair's done. She's going to whip off the towel. She's going to have a full leather outfit on.
Of course. No. Her husband is going to come out
my
and blow
tiara
dry
wouldn't
it.
Fit under the towel.
That's right.
Kids are going to come out with wardrobe changes. She's got the whole house working for her. Let's take a look at that mug real quick.
It's true. Maxim just fixed the lighting.
Can we take a look at your mug?
Oh, sorry. Yeah. So this one, I actually meant to change it. Sorry. I meant to change this ahead of time. This is just from Barista Parlor in Nashville. We were there this summer. I don't know when we're going to get back to Nashville. I don't know when travel is going to resume to normal, but this is where we were in Nashville. It was a really great spot. I actually hadn't meant to use this mug. I forgot to switch it. Hey, I want to tell you, speaking of getting back to normal, I want to tell you about some people who, before they entered a high-profile job of either acting, directing, or politics, used to be doctors. And because of this crisis, they've gone back. I want to start with the Prime Minister of Ireland. He's known as the Taoiseach there. Leo Varadkar. So he was a medical doctor. He had worked as a GP for several years. And
back in March, the crisis was getting bad. He registered back as a doctor. So now he's been doing shifts once a week. He's doing the phone assessments so that he can free up hospital staff to like be at work in the hospitals. So I thought that was a really cool story. The other one is in England. This is really neat. Bashka Mukherjee, she's Miss England 2019. Before that, she was a respiratory doctor, and she had planned to put it on hold until she could do some work with her job as Miss England, doing some charity work until the summer. But she started getting emails from her colleagues back at the hospital describing how difficult it is, the challenging conditions, how exhausted they were. So she signed back on. She's in isolation for 2 weeks now, and then she'll head back into rotation in the hospitals for the foreseeable future. So Miss England's crown is on hold. I also have some two great Canadian examples. You might have heard a couple of these. Brian Levy, of course, or Levy, he is the former CEO of Radio Shack. He had been a doctor for a number of years. He went to school, med school, in fact, at McMaster University in Hamilton. He is now, right now, an ER doctor working in Emerge at Brampton Civic Hospital, and he will be there for the foreseeable future, helping out through this crisis. And then, of course, Jane Philpott, the former MP and the former health minister, who was a doctor for a number of years. She will be taking on a new dean of a medical facility. But in the meantime, she has also gone back into shift work at the Markham Stouffville Hospital. That's, of course, in her riding. And then this last one I love. This is a French director. His name is Thomas Lilty. He was a doctor for 15 years before he left the profession a few years ago. He has written a medical drama film. It was called Hypocrite. It was then turned into a television series. And he was in the middle of shooting the series when the outbreak happened. So now he's back at the hospital, actually the same hospital where the show was being shot. And that show, by the way, has donated all of its masks to hospital work. So just a few people who had high-profile jobs and have gone back to their jobs as medical staff so that they can help out during the pandemic, during the crisis.
That's amazing.
It's amazing. The sacrifice.
I've also gone back to my regular job.
Yeah. Yes.
I knew your hair was under there. All done.
These are people who built successful careers elsewhere, yeah, and they're going back to the front lines. I mean, that's
incredible.
It's a calling, right, for a lot of these people, for a lot of these doctors, these frontline workers who know that as tired as they are, the danger that they're putting themselves in, they have to do it. So our hats are off to each and every one of them.
Absolutely. And your towel's off. So we'll see what happens next hit when we see you. Anne-Marie, thanks so much. Those are great stories.
Thanks for watching. If you like this, be sure to subscribe here.
And you can check out more Your Morning videos right here.